mean that if they go to the priest or the pastor, fibroid can be healed. People believe if you tell them that, oh, you have very low sperm count, they say, I reject it. I reject it, and by, in the name of, they will mention whatever God, it will not happen. So what are some of the things that has now happened? With the awareness, men, see, when you say that 50% of infertility is due to men, it's wrong. I tell my patient, actually, you are either 100% fertile or 0%. And in most cases, when these men have infertility, the wife is normal, but the man does not come to the clinic. So you are busy treating this normal patient. And sometimes this normal patient, they go to doctors who perform surgery on them. And they perform surgery and surgery. And by the time you see this patient coming for in vitro fertilization, the man has zero sperm. So in the guidelines now, and I think we will pass the WHO guidelines to most, which is now being circulated to most people in Africa. Sperm analysis is the easiest thing to perform in infertility. So men must accompany their wife to the clinic. It should be a mandatory thing. And we found out that when men follow the wife to the clinic, the success rate for fertility is high. So, and there are so many, many other levels in mind. And what I can now tell you is that 20 years ago, I could not tell people that my clinic is a fertility clinic. In fact, people could not want others to know that the baby they have was through seeing a doctor. That is how bad it is. But today, people are now coming and saying, yes, my baby was through surrogacy. So there is now acceptance. And so we're on the road to improvement for the benefit of mankind, especially women. So I think I'd like to cut the